Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. It is Brittany here and welcome back to another Halloween Horror Nights video. So let's jump right on into it. Another speculation map from Horror Night Nightmares, and this is volume 3.5, I want to say. It's Monday morning as I'm filming this, and so now we have scare zones and house locations pretty much locked in. We have 3 houses left, and we have all scare zones and shows left, and it's only June. Things are gonna be really ramping up here if they haven't already, and we've gotten some construction already in the park from what I've seen on Twitter. It's getting very exciting. I honestly cannot wait to be back in September. So let's go ahead and go through the houses that have yet to be announced. So I'm going to start in Soundstage 23B, and this is where the rumored Ghostbusters Frozen Empire house is going to be. We've yet to get the announcement for Ghostbusters, and I think it's going to be happening pretty soon, within the next month. Now I'm moving on to Soundstage 24A, and this is rumored to be Insidious. Now we don't know which Insidious, but I'm betting probably the first 2 films and then the most recent. Or they could do a best of house and have all 5 movies. We'll see once it gets announced. And now in Tent 4, this is our Universal Monsters house, and it's gonna be based on the female monsters. So now we're gonna move on to scare zone locations, and the scare zone locations actually have not changed from last year. So I'm gonna start with the front of the park, Plaza of the Stars, or the front gates. And this could be our icon zone that we saw at the end of the teaser video that we had a couple weeks ago, whose name we now know is Otis. I'll put in a picture of him where I can find it. Yeah, he looks really cool, and I think he's one of the major icons this year. I've heard rumors of there being like a superior icon over him. So we'll see. I hope we get the front gates and the arches all decked out this year, because I know before I started going, they were really decking it out, and hopefully they bring that back this year. So for Hollywood, this would be our potential Blumhouse zone, and this basically would be like our scare zone we had at 28. Where it took a character or something from each of the houses. This would be our table content zone, basically, but with Blumhouse movies. I'm thinking we could see Megan, Freaky, The Black Phone, Halloween, The Purge, and then one of their more recent films. They have a lot to work with, and I think this would be also one of the photo op zones as well, which isn't the best. But it's gonna be cool to hopefully see all these characters in one zone together. So Central Park, I absolutely have no idea what this is or what it could be. I'm looking forward to seeing when we do find out what it is. So in San Francisco, if you watched my last video, I said it was evil dolls or something based on Japanese lore. But now they're saying it could be being based on evil toys. Has me intrigued. I'm not crazy about the location, because San Francisco usually gets very crowded and it's hard to get through, but I'm excited to see how they make the area work. Maybe they'll extend the zone a little bit. into where Fast and Furious is. So for New York, but now they're saying this could be a Dia de los Muertos festival. For those of you who don't know what that means, it's basically Day of the Dead. Basically, it's a tradition every year where people will honor those who have passed. And I think this will be one of the more colorful zones that we have, and I'm excited. So that is it for this video, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it. Based on the last three houses that we have left and our scare zones that have now started to come to fruition, looking to be a great year. I'm a little nervous for the scare zones this year, so we'll see once they get announced and once the event starts. And yeah, so I will see you guys in the next one and in the fog. Bye, guys.